Have you ever wondered why your wife is called Lao Po or your husband Lao Gong? Or why everyday words like things are called 东西, which literally means east, west? In this series, we are diving deep into the fascinating backstories of common Chinese words you use every day without a second thought. Get ready as we reveal the hidden layers of meaning behind Chinese vocabulary. Each word has its own story to tell. The story of this Chinese word originated in Shanxian County. There was a poor scholar, although a brilliant man of wide learning, could not pass the civil service examination because he lacked influential connections. When he failed the examination for the third time, he gave up and turned to weaving bamboo baskets for a living. After he had mastered the trade, he started selling bamboo baskets in the market. When someone bought his baskets, he would write his or her name on it using a brush and ink. His reputation grew because his baskets were sturdy and well made. Moreover, the calligraphy was beautiful as well. One day, a man from his county left to the capital with two baskets of presents for the prime minister. He was not interested in the presents, but only the calligraphy on the baskets. After learning that the scholar wrote the wordings on the basket, he asked the man to pass an invitation letter to the poor scholar. When the poor scholar came, the prime minister asked him to demonstrate his calligraphy skills. He was greatly impressed with his writing skills, as well as his knowledge in the four books and five classics. The prime minister asked the scholar, "What is the use of the bamboo basket?" He answered, "It can hold the east and the west," which means Dong Si in Chinese. The prime minister then asked, "Can it hold the north and the south too?" "No," the scholar said. "What about the center?" "Yes, just a little," answered the scholar. The scholar continued to explain that in the yin and yang and the five elements, east represented wood and west represented metal. All things made of wood and metals can be carried in a basket, as north represented water and south represented fire. They cannot be placed in a basket. Center represented the earth or soil, thus can only hold a little. As the prime minister was amazed with his knowledge and talent, he recommended him to the emperor. The poor scholar later became a magistrate of Shanxian County, and Dongxi later became a widely and daily used Chinese word. Meaning of the Chinese word 东西 or 东西. Number 1. Directions. When referring to directions, the pronunciation is 东西. Sentence example. 朝东西方向走就 能看到了。朝东西方向走就能看到了。 You can see it by heading towards the east-west direction. Number 2. Referring to concrete or abstract things. When referring to things, the pronunciation is 东西. Sentence examples: 吃东西, 吃东西, eat something, food. 把东西放好, 把东西放好, put the things away properly. Number 3. Referring to people or animal. Sentence examples. 这小东西很顽皮. 这小东西很顽皮. This little kid is very naughty. 别和这脏东西玩. 别和这脏东西玩. Don't play with this dirty puppy. Number 4. Scolding words. Sentence examples. 你算什么东西? 你算什么东西? Who do you think you are? 你真不是个东西? 你真不是个东西? You are such a jerk. Story of the Chinese word 上当. This Chinese word 上当 came about during the Qing Guangxu reign period. In that period, there was a rich family surnamed Wang. They owned a profitable pawn shop in the city, and the business was growing in leaps and bounds. However, after a few years in the business, they grew tired and decided to hire a manager to run the business for them so that they could pursue leisure rather than toiling in the shop. The manager who was running the pawn business had no interest in the business at all. He was more interested in books. As such, the Wangs wanted to get some money for themselves and started to bring useless things from home to pawn at their own shop. The Wang set the prices and the manager had to give them whatever they asked. Within a few months, the pawn shop ran out of capital and the manager had to borrow from other businesses. However, as the pawn shop had no capital, the manager could not pay off the loan. In less than a year, the pawn shop went bankrupt. Due to this, the people in the village composed a jingle. 清和王自上当, to make fun of the Wang of cheating from their own shop. In those days, pawning articles was known as 上当. As the pawn shop went bankrupt due to Wang's own self-deceit, these words in Chinese became a synonym for being cheated or suffers loss. Let's learn some new words from this story. 当铺, 当铺, pawn shop. 经理, 经理, manager. 兴趣, 兴趣, interest. 没用的东西, 没用的东西, useless things. 典当, 典当, to pawn. 破产, 破产 bankrupt, 上当上当 cheated. Sentence examples of 上当别上他的当别上他的当 Don't be fooled by him. 他不听劝告结果上当受骗他不听劝告结果上当受骗 He did not listen to advice and was deceived. Chui Niu comprises of two Chinese words. Chui is equivalent to the English word to blow. Niu is the meaning of cow in English. Chui Niu literally means blow the cow. Story of Chui Niu. The first story is about a couple who often quarrel. The husband was a frail and small person, whereas the wife was tall and strong. Whenever they fought, the husband was no match for the wife. One day, the couple quarreled again, and the husband was pushed to the ground. After this incident, the more the husband thought about it, the angrier he became, that he left home to learn martial arts at the Shaolin Temple. At Shaolin Temple, the martial art teacher taught him to blow wind twice towards the bottom of the well before he drew water from the well. These carried on for 3 years, and he became incredibly powerful. After mastering the skills, he finally went home. The next day, he and the wife went out to herd their cow. Suddenly, the cow refused to move, and the wife carried the cow over the bridge without uttering anything. When the husband saw this, he was speechless as to how strong the wife had become. It turns out that all these 3 years, the wife had been carrying the cow over the bridge since it was a calf. As days passed, the calf grew and her strength increased as well. Upon seeing this, the husband wanted to show off the skill he had learned. He quickly blew at the cow and it fell into the river. This incident quickly spread into the village. However, nobody believed that a person could actually blow a cow. After this, people started using this Chinese phrase, Chui Niu, to describe a person who likes to brag or talk speak. The second story is about blowing the skin of a cow. This Chinese phrase originated in the upper reaches of the Yellow River. In ancient times, as the transportation system was not developed, it was difficult for people to use wooden boats to navigate through Qinghai, Gansu, Ningxia, Shaanxi, and other provinces via the Yellow River. This was because the current was too strong and the boat would be crushed by the rapid water. In order to solve this problem, villages along the upper reaches of the Yellow River used skin raft instead of boats to navigate the river. These skin wraps were made of sheep skin or cow hide. When the villagers slaughter cows and sheep, they would firstly peel off the whole skin of the cow and sheep, then use salt water to scald the whole skin. After that, they would then apply vegetable oil to the limbs and neck, and finally soak it in water. Lastly, they would expose it under the sun in order to soften the skin. Once softened, they would sew it into a bag with string, leaving only one hole, one small hole, for blowing air into it. After blowing enough air into the small hole, they sealed the small hole tightly and then fixed multiple skin bags under a wooden raft to turn it into a skin raft. In ancient times, as there were no air pumps, the people had to blow air with their mouth so as to fill air into the sheepskin bag. As sheepskin bag was small, it was possible for a person with a large lung capacity to fill air with his mouth. However, this was not the case for a cowhide bag. As it was large, it was impossible for one person to blow it directly with the mouth. If the cowhide bag was to be filled with air, it required several adults with large lung capacity to do the job. Therefore, if someone in the upper reaches of the Yellow River said that he could blow a cowhide bag, the local people would not believe a word, and they would think that he was talking big. And to those who liked to brag about themselves, the local residents would say, "If you are really capable, go to the Yellow River to blow the cowhide." Since then, blow the cowhide became synonymous with bragging and became a widely used Chinese phrase. New words, 新词语. 夫妻, 夫妻, husband and wife. 吵架, 吵架, quarrel. 体弱, 体弱, frail. 推倒在地, 推倒在地, push to the ground. 越想越生气, 越想, 越生气. The more one thinks, the angrier one gets. 挑井水, 挑井水, draws water from the well. 力大无比, 力大无比, incredibly powerful. 放牛, 放牛, herding cows. 二话不说, 二话不说, not uttering anything further. 日复一日, 日复一日, as days passed. 露一手, 露一手, show off a skill. 吹牛皮, 吹牛皮, bragging. 疲乏, 疲乏, skin wrapped. 肺活量, 肺活量, lung capacity. How to use 吹牛? 他因为总爱吹牛, 所以没人相信他说的话。 他因为总 爱吹牛，所以没人相信他说的话。他因为总爱吹牛，所以没人相信他说的话。Because he always likes to brag, nobody believes what he says. 吹牛吹多了会让人反感。吹牛吹多了会让人反感。吹牛吹多了会让人反感。Too much bragging will make people feel disgusted. Similar meaning of 吹牛。说大话，说大话，说大话， boast or talk big. 夸口，夸口，夸口， boast. 夸耀，夸耀，夸耀， boast. 吹嘘，吹嘘，吹嘘， brag. 吹捧，吹捧，吹捧， to praise highly. Opposite meaning of 吹牛，自谦，自谦，自谦， to humble oneself. 谦虚，谦虚，谦虚，to be humble. The story we are sharing today is about why husbands are called 老公 and wives are called 老婆 in Chinese. The story of 老公 and 老婆 happened in the Tang Dynasty. There was a famous scholar by the name of Mai Xing. When he had obtained fame after passing the civil exam, he saw his wife of many years was catching up with age and started to have the idea of abandoning the old for the new. However, as they have been married for years, Mai dare not tell the wife bluntly. One day, when he was in the room studying, the wife came in to serve him some refreshments. Mai then took this opportunity to write her a couplet. 和拜连蚕落叶归根成老藕。The lotus withered and the fallen leaves returned to the roots to become an old lotus. When the wife read the words, she understood what the husband was trying to tell her. Knowing that she was no longer young, she could not help feeling emotional. She then took the pen from her husband and wrote the second part of the couplet to counter his. 和黄道熟吹康见米现心凉。The grain ripened, blow the chaff to see rice, and new grain appears. The wife used grain to counter lotus and new grain to counter old lotus. The metaphor was very appropriately used. The Chinese word 新娘 sounds like 新娘, which means bride in English. When Mai read what his wife wrote, he was blown away by her cleverness. He thought back and forth and started to have guilty conscience. He dismissed the idea of divorcing his wife to remarry. When the wife saw that the husband had repented, she wrote, "Lao Gong, Shi Fen, Gong Dao." My husband is very fair. The husband then replied, "Lao Po, Yi Pian, Po Xin." My wife is kind-hearted. The phrase "Lao Gong" and "Lao Po" thus refer to husbands and wives growing old together, and this phrase also became a term of endearment for husbands and wives. New words, 新词语, 念头, 念头, idea, 喜新厌旧, 喜新厌旧, abandoning the old for the new. 直言, 直言, to say bluntly. 思前想后, 思前想后, thinking back and forth. 良心责备, 良心责备, guilty conscience. 打消, 打消, dismiss. 爱称, 爱称, terms of endearment. Other ways to say 老公 and 老婆. For 老公, you can also say 先生, 先生, 丈夫, or 丈夫, 丈夫, 丈夫. 爱人, 爱人, 老伴, 老伴. The last two phrases, 爱人 and 老伴, can be used when referring to your wife. For 老婆, you can also say 妻子, 妻子, 夫人, 夫人, 太太, 太太, 内人, 内人. Funny terms for 老公 and 老婆. Funny terms for 老公, 不正经的, 不正经的, the not serious one. 没出息的, 没出息的, the useless one. 不争气的, 不争气的, the disappointing one. 窝囊废, 窝囊废, good for nothing. Funny terms for 老婆, 烧火婆, 烧火婆, the one in charge of the kitchen. 黄脸婆, 黄脸婆, literally means yellow-faced woman. 黄脸婆, this phrase is used by the husband when the wife is getting old and doesn't really pay attention to her appearance. 孩他妈, 孩他妈, the children's mother. 那口子, 那口子, 口子, other half. These funny terms for 老公 and 老婆, other than 孩他妈 and 那口子, are usually used when the husbands and wives are at odds with each other. Normally, we don't really use these terms. Today, you are going to find out how this Chinese expression 加油 came about. The Chinese expression 加油 literally means add oil. 加 is add and 油 is oil. It is popularly used in colloquial conversations in Chinese as a form of encouragement or support. This Chinese expression took place during the Warring State period, 战国时期. There was a general by the name of Yue Yi from the state of Yan. Yue Yi was a brave and brilliant warrior. He led an army into the state of Qi and obtained victory. The king of Qi fled the country with haste. During that time, there was a court official living in the capital of Qi called Tian Dan. Tian Dan was a person who planned ahead and thoughtful. Before he fled Qi with his household, he told the man to saw off the protruded axle of the carriages and to cover them with iron sheet. And he also instructed them to put a few bottles of sesame oil in the carriages. When his carriages exited the city gate, it was jammed packed with people trying to flee the country. Many of the carriages were destroyed because of collision. Many had to abandon their carriages because of broken axle. As Tian Dan had modified his carriages beforehand, all 10 of them exited the city gate undamaged. Moreover, as other carriages lubricated their axle with animal fat, after long hours of traveling, they would produce loud squeaky noise, and the speed of the carriage would become slower and slower. However, the horseman dare not alight to check due to the dire situation. Tian Dan's carriages, on the other hand, were brisk and far ahead from others. Whenever the carriages slowed down, the man would shout, "Jia You, quick, Jia You," and they would put sesame oil on the axle. The carriages would then increase speed again. When the other carriages heard them shouting, "Jia You," they thought they were encouraging each other by saying that. As such, they followed Tian Dan and the man by shouting, "Jia You," from the capital of Qi till they reached Qimo. From then onwards, the Chinese expression 加油 became a form of encouragement used in sporting events and competitions by groups as a form of cheering each other. This expression can also be used at a personal level as a motivating phrase to the partner in the conversation. New words. 新词语大将大将 general 英勇善战英勇善战 brave and brilliant warrior 率领率领 lead, to lead. 仓皇, 逃跑. 仓皇, 逃跑. To flee with haste. 首都, 首都, 都, the capital. 有心计, a person who plans ahead. 周到, thoughtful. 芝麻油, sesame oil. 碰撞, collision. 抛弃, abandon. 完好无损, undamaged. 遥遥领先, far ahead. How to use 加油? The Chinese expression 加油 has two meanings. Firstly, to mean to refuel or to add lubricating oil to a vehicle. 我的汽车需要加油。 My car needs gas. 请问加油站在哪里? 请问加油站在哪里? Where is the gas station? Meaning number two, to encourage, support, or cheer someone on. 球迷们都在为各自的球队加油。球迷们都在为各自的球队加油。 Fans are cheering for their respective teams. 明天的面试不要紧张,我会给你加油。Don't be nervous for tomorrow's interview. I will cheer you on. Today, we are going to do a Chinese word story called 千金小姐. 千 in English means 1,000. 金 is gold. 小姐 means miss. So, this Chinese word 千金小姐 literally means 1,000 gold miss in English. 有个大财主，家财万贯，妻妾无房，但是没有子女。他到处求医问药，烧香拜佛，都没有用。好不容易在他大约50多岁的时候，老来得子，他的小老婆。 给他生了个女儿，但是长得很丑。女儿因为长得很丑，所以长大后却找不到对象，嫁不出去。财主费尽心思，终于通过媒婆给他的女儿找对象，也是有钱人家的儿子，但是他是个傻子。 所以已经30多岁的人都没成家，双方家长选择吉日让他们成亲。成亲那天，新娘下了花轿后，觉得盖头蒙着脸走路不方便，就把她取下，结果露出了脸。到访的客人见着都惊叫了起来，说。 这新娘比鬼还难看，婆家的人看到后，便生气地叫媒婆把新娘抬回去。媒婆无法拒绝，只好把新娘抬到大财主门口。 大财主见后说，嫁出去的女儿犹如泼出去的水，不想要这女儿了。媒婆觉得不合适，便恳求财主收回她之前说的话。财主听了媒婆的话后又说，我给女儿千两黄金当陪嫁，谁愿意娶她就嫁给谁吧。那时候正好是午时，热得要命，新娘便从轿子走出来。媒婆见着，便从看热闹的人群中选了一个穿着破烂的小伙子，拉到新娘的面前，然后问她，你愿意娶她为妻吗？小伙子看了新娘后说，愿意，丑没关系，丑妻是个宝，定会给我生个大胖子。新娘见小伙子长得挺好看，非常乐意嫁给他，他们就这样成了亲，成为夫妻。婚后他们非常的幸福，乡亲们没有不羡慕和赞叹他们俩的，他们都说丑妻有丑福，并称丑妻为千金小姐。千金小姐这称呼就流传至今，成为对他人女儿的一种称谓。 Let us go through this story once again in English. 很久以前 means long long ago. 有个大财主 means there's one rich man. 家财万贯means he has a lot of money. 妻妾五房 means wives and concubines. 但是没有子女，但是 but 没有 don't have 子女 sons or daughters. 他到处求医问药 means he has been searching around for doctors and medicines. 烧香拜佛 means burning incense and praying to the deities, 都没有用, but all in vain. 好不容易 means finally, 在他大约五十多岁的时候, when he was around 50 plus years old, 老来得子, he finally got a child. 他的小老婆小老婆 means the second wife, 给她生了个女儿, gave birth to a daughter, 但是长得很丑, but she was very ugly. 丑 means ugly. 女儿因为长得很丑, 因为 is because, 长得很丑 means she was very ugly, 所以Therefore, 长大后, when she grew up, 却找不到对象。找不到 means cannot find, 对象 means object, or in this context is the husband, 嫁不出去, and she couldn't get married. 财主费尽心思 means the rich man racked his brain, 终于通过媒婆给他的女儿找对象, finally went through a woman matchmaker and found a husband for the daughter. 也是个有钱人家的儿子, and he is also from a rich family. 但是他是个傻子, but he was a fool. 所以已经三十多岁的人都没成家。Therefore, he didn't get married even when he was already more than 30 years old. 双方家长选择吉日 means both the families selected an auspicious day, 让他们成亲 and let them get married. 成亲那天, on the day of the wedding, 新娘 下了花轿后, when the bride got off from the bridal sedan chair, 觉得盖头蒙着脸, 走路不方便, 就把它取下, she felt the bridal veil 盖头, 蒙着脸, covering the face, 走路, walking, 不方便, not convenient, 就把它取下, therefore she took it off. 结果露出了脸, 结果 means as a result, 露出 means exposed, 脸 means the face, so as a result, her face was exposed. 到访的客人见着都惊叫起来说, 到访的客人, those invited guests, 见着 means saw, 都 means all of them, 惊叫 means scream, and said, 这新娘比鬼还难看, 这新娘, this bride, 比 means compare, 鬼 means the ghost, 还难看 means this bride is uglier than a ghost. 婆家的人, 婆家的人 means the bridegroom's family. 看到后, after they saw, 变 here means once. 生气, 生气 is angry. 叫 means to call or to ask. 媒婆, the matchmaker, 把新娘抬回去, means to carry the bride back home. So once the bridegroom's family saw this, they were very angry and asked the matchmaker to carry the bride back home. 媒婆无法拒绝，只好把新娘抬到大财主门口。无法拒绝 means could not reject. 只好 means had to. So the matchmaker could not reject and had to bring the bride back to the rich man's house. 大财主见后说, so the rich man, after he saw this, he said, 嫁出去的女儿 means the married daughter. 有如 is like 泼出去的水 means poured out water. 不想要 means do not want 这女儿了, this daughter, anymore. 媒婆觉得不合适, 不合适 means not suitable or not right. So the matchmaker thought it was not right. 便恳求, 恳求 means to plead. 财主收回, means to take back. 他之前, before, 说的话, so it means the matchmaker thought it was not right and thus pleaded with the rich man to take back what he had just said. 财主听了媒婆的话后, when the rich man heard what the matchmaker had said, 又说, he said again, 我给女儿, I give the daughter 千两黄金, 2,000 gold pieces, 当陪嫁, as her dowry. 谁愿意娶她就嫁给谁吧, whoever wants to marry her, I will just let her marry. 那时候正好是午时, at that time, it was exactly mid-noon, 热得要命, was terribly hot. 新娘便从轿子走出来, so the bride came out from the sedan chair. 媒婆见着, means when the matchmaker saw this, 便从看热闹, 看热闹 means the rubberneckers or those who were there to watch the fun. 的人群中, 人群中 means from the crowd. 选了一个, 选了一个 means to select a one. 穿着破烂, the 小伙子. 穿着破烂 means in clothes in rags. 小伙子 means a young guy or young man. 拉到新娘的面前 means dragged him to the bride. 然后问他 and then ask him, 你愿意娶她为妻吗? Do you want to marry her? 小伙子看了新娘后说, when the young guy saw the bride, he said, 愿意, he said, yes, I do. 丑没关系, he says, being ugly is not a problem. 丑妻是个宝, an ugly wife is a treasure. 定会给我生个大胖子, she will definitely give birth to a plump son for me. 新娘见小伙子, 长得挺好看, means the bride saw that the young man was rather handsome, 非常乐意嫁给他, she was very happy to marry him. 他们就这样成了亲, 成为夫妻, so they got married and became husband and wife. 婚后他们非常的幸福, they were happily married. 乡亲们, the villagers, 没有不羡慕, 羡慕 means envy. 赞叹, 赞叹 means admire. 他们两, 他们两 means the husband and the wife. So it means the villagers envied and admired the married couple. 他们都说, means all of them said, 丑妻有丑福, 丑妻, ugly wives, 有 means to have, 丑福, ugly blessings. 并称, also called 丑妻, call the ugly wife 为千金小姐, call the ugly wife as thousand gold miss. 千金小姐 literally means thousand gold miss. This title has been handed down to the present. 称呼 means the title. 流传至 Jin means handed down to the present. 成为 become 对他人女儿的一种称谓, became a title for someone else's daughter. That's a wrap for today's video. If you found this video helpful, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you never miss a lesson. See you next time. And as always, happy learning!